Hi viewers, welcome to LMS Solution. Today we are going to see about regenerative braking in BLDC motor driven electric vehicle. So thanks for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for notification about upcoming videos. So directly we are going to see about a simulation of regenerative braking in BLDC motor and driven electric vehicle. So this is a Simulink model developed for that concept. Okay, so it consists of a battery, and then here we have converter, buck converter, and this is nothing but voltage source inverter, and this is nothing but BLDC motor. And BLDC motor having hall sensor, decoder and control logic for generating the pulse for this voltage source inverter. And also this hall sensor decoding logic is combined with the braking concept, braking and running concept. So here we are going to measure the speed of the BLDC motor, and then it's going to be compared with the reference speed command, and then it's going to be processed via PID controller. It's going to be generate a duty cycle, and then this duty cycle is processed via PWM generator, and then it's going to be used for drive the IGBT of the buck converter to control the speed of the BLDC motor. Okay, so here you can see that we are using a 6 series battery, 12 volt battery, and then rated capacity of the battery is 150 Ah, and then initial state of charge of battery is 50%. Okay, and then this is 500 watts BLDC motor. Okay, 500 watts 48 volt BLDC motor. So this 72 volt is going to be converted into around 60 volt. That means we have to provide 48 volt supply for the BLDC motor. Okay, and then here we are using a voltage source inverter here. So this inverter going to be driven by hall sensor control logic, and also here you can see here this is a all decoder under and gate signal generation for the voltage source inverter. And also here we are combining that concept of running and braking concept here, so not to get the energy from BLDC motor during the braking condition, right? So that means during braking the energy, the kinetic energy in this BLDC motor going to be fed back to the battery. Okay, so for that we are created this control logic, right? So this logic used to run the motor. Okay, and then this logic used for applying the braking concept. Okay, and then here we are applying that that control logic for generating the pulse. Okay, so it will generate 6 pulse. This 6 pulse going to be combined with the running command logic and braking command logic. Okay, so this going to be control the voltage source inverter in order to running command as well as braking command. Okay, so here you can see here, right? The running command, right? That mean we are going to simulate this model. So up to 5 seconds, right? System going to be in the running mode, right? After 5 seconds, it goes to braking mode. Okay, so for that we are that mean providing this control logic here. Okay, and also during braking, so we need to generate some braking pulse. Okay, so that pulse going to be generated based upon battery current, right? So here you get to measure the battery current and process via PA controller, and then based upon this PA control output, we have to generate the pulse. Okay, so this pulse going to be combined with this running and braking command signal. Okay, so this signal, right, this that mean braking pulse, right, the braking pulse going to be combined with this logic. Okay, all sensor, decoder and control logic to control this voltage source inverter during that braking condition. Okay, so here that initially the mean reference speed is maintained at 3000 rpm. So from 0 to 5 seconds, the speed of the BLDC motor maintained at 3000 rpm. So after that, just you have to apply that braking command. So during that command, the energy will be flow from this BLDC motor and voltage source inverter, and then via this diode with the battery. Okay, so now we are going to simulate this model and you will get the detail about this. Okay, right, so first I'm going to simulate this model, and then I'm going to show you that the speed of the machine. Right, now you can see that the speed of the machine is maintained at 3000 rpm, so it's under running condition. So reference speed is 3000 rpm. okay, and you can see the battery detail here, and then so here you can see the torque of the BLDC motor. So this is the speed of the BLDC motor. So this is voltage across the voltage source inverter. So now you can see that the braking will be applied at 5 seconds. So because of that, you can see that BLDC motor speed is reduced to 0. During that time, you can see that the torque, right, torque of the BLDC motor goes to negative, right? So this known as that energy, right, kinetic energy, that energy going to be used is to charge the battery during the braking condition. So here you can see that I will zoom that part, right, here you can see that. So here, because of that that energy during that braking, right, is fed back to the battery. Okay, so because of that, the current of the battery, right, is goes to negative. So current of the battery is goes to negative means that mean it get the power from the BLDC motor during braking, right? So battery is charging, right? So because of this negative current, you can see the SOC of the battery. So SOC of the battery is increasing. Okay, you can see here that the SOC of the battery is increasing because of that regenerative energy, right? And also you can see the battery voltage are going to be increases from 71.5 to 71.6, right? So during this braking, right, the energy in the BLDC motor in the form of kinetic energy that going to be transferred to the battery to charge for the short time. Okay, so this is the concept of regenerative braking in the BLDC motor for electric vehicle application. Thank you for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for a notification about upcoming videos. Thank you once again.